Hey there, Mercedes here from PrettyWebz.com, and today I'm going to show you how to make a jade texture inside of Photoshop. Before we get started, I want to show you the resources that I used to create this texture. So right here, I have just a couple of images. These two images I used as a reference for the actual texture and the veining that you see in jade. And I also use these images to sample colors. So right here is the jade color palette. This is what we're going to be using to create our own texture. And then I was using this one right here to kind of create a layer style. So I do have a layer style. I'm not going to show you how to create this layer style in this video, but I am going to leave a link down in the description so you can download it and use it. So these two are objects that I made using the jade texture and then just a simple layer style. So if I remove that, you can see that it's just a flat shape. The same thing with this one. So I'll go ahead and leave you this layer style so that you can have it available if you'd like to use it. And I'll also leave you all of the colors that we're going to be using in the description as well. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to come up here to File, New. And our document for this is going to be 1920 by 1080 resolution, 96 RGB. We're in 8-bit. And I'm going to go ahead and click Create. I'm going to unlock this layer, right click, and choose Convert to Smart Object. Now over here, make sure that you have your default foreground and background colors. You can just click on that little icon right there to bring those back to default. So black on top, white on the bottom. Now we're going to come up to Filter, Render, Clouds, and then again, Filter, Render, this time Difference Clouds. Now on your keyboard, Command and the letter L or Control and the letter L to bring up your levels. Now I'm doing it this way because I don't want a separate layer for this. I want these all to be here in my smart filters. So I used that shortcut in order to get there. So I pretty much know what I want this to look like. So I'm going to just go ahead and put in my values. So this middle value is going to be 3. This one is 0. And this one is going to be 96. So what we're trying to do is just bring out some veining here. Typically, these are the settings that will usually get me to this point. So I usually use those settings. So I'm going to click OK. Now I'm going to come back up to Filter. This time Filter Gallery, and I already have these all set up right here. These are the four filters that we're going to be using. I'm going to walk through them with you really quickly. So the first one that we're going to use is called Sponge. That's in the Artistic folder right here, and the settings for the one that we're creating is Brush Size 2, our Definition is 25, and our Smoothness is 2. The next filter is going to be this one, a chalk and charcoal filter. This one is right here in the sketch folder, and it's the second one here. I'm working in Photoshop 2020, so these might be in different places if you're using an older version, but they're pretty much all going to be there. So the chalk and charcoal settings are going to be charcoal area 3, chalk area 8, stroke pressure is going to be 2. And now we're going to add a plastic wrap. And for a plastic wrap, that's going to be inside of Artistic. Then plastic wrap. Our settings for this one are going to be highlight strength 6, detail 10, and our smoothness is 5. Now we're going to add another plastic wrap. And if you don't know how to add these, all you do is just come here and press that little plus icon, and it's going to add another one. But for us, we're going to use plastic wrap again, so we have two of these. For this top one, our highlight strength is going to be 15, our detail is going to be 15, and our smoothness is going to be 3. So that's going to be all of our settings for our filter gallery. I'm going to click OK, and you're going to have something that looks like this. It's pretty rough at this point. We're going to go ahead and add another filter. But instead of coming down here, we're going to grab a gradient map. But if we did it this way, it's just going to add it to the top. And I want this to be part of our smart filter. So I'm going to go ahead and delete that. And I'm going to come here to Image, Adjustments. And I'm going to grab the gradient map from there. That way we can have that right here in our smart filters as well. I'm going to add a specific gradient. Again, I'm going to leave you a link to these as well down in the description, but I will quickly show you the settings for these. So this first one, there's going to be three. This is the jade bottom, middle, and top. We're going to add a few other layers here in a minute, but we're going to be working with this one first. And the settings for this are going to be location 0%, and the color we're using is 5B9258 for that one. And then we have this at location 100, and that color is going to be 96A888, and we'll click OK. This is going to be our very first layer. This is the bottom. So I'm going to go ahead and right click, duplicate this layer. This is going to be the middle. And I'm going to right click and duplicate that layer again. This is going to be the top. So we're going to have three layers here, the bottom, middle, and the top layer. So our goal with all of these layers is just to get a little bit of dimension. So when you look at something like jade or any type of rock that's somewhat transparent, most likely you can see veining in all of the texture that goes deep inside of the rock. So that's what we're trying to get here. So we're just going to use these. I'm going to turn this one off. I'm going to come here to this middle, and I'm going to change the blending mode to soft light. Again, these two layers are just going to be veining and the texture that's deeper inside of the rock. So for this one, I'm going to come back here to gradient map. Just double click on that. If you click here, it's just going to give you a percentage of your opacity. We actually want to change the effect itself. So we're going to double click on the name here, and I'm going to click on that gradient and come back down here, and I'm going to choose this one. This is our jade middle. And let me quickly show you the settings here. Location 0 is going to be 5B9258. Location 41, 82B58A. And location 100 is C9E2B7. So that is going to be our middle gradient. I'm going to click OK and OK again. Now for this, because we want our veining to be a little bit different than it is here at the bottom. So right now we have, it's exactly the same, just in different colors. So what we're going to do is come over to the clouds and double click and just click OK. And all that's going to do is change that cloud render. Again, we're going to do the same thing with the difference clouds. And you can see how the veining of this one changed a little bit. So now the veining is showing up in different areas. So that's our middle layer. And now we're going to turn on the top layer. This top layer will set to soft light. And we're going to double click on the gradient. And again, I've already set up this gradient. So this is going to be the top. So this is jade top. Let me give you the settings for these quickly. We have location 0, and that is 5B9258. Our center, this one is at 54, and the number there is 95A986. And location 100, 82B58A. And we'll click OK. So that's going to be our top layer. Again, we're going to come over to the clouds and difference clouds, double click, just to switch that veining around a little bit. The same thing for the difference clouds. Now that we have all of this, we can come over here to edit, define pattern. We're going to call this jade. Click OK. I'm going to add a new layer here and just fill it with white. And I'm just gonna grab the ellipse tool and just make a quick circle here. Let's fill that with, it doesn't even matter with what it's filled with, because we're just gonna add that layer style to that. Okay, so with this ellipse selected, I'm going to come over to my effects. This is going to be the effect that I just created. So you can see this image is smaller than the one I showed you previously with all the samples on it. So this is going to be pretty big. It looks like it's just floating around there. So what I'm going to do is come over here to the effects, right click, and I'm going to click on scale effects. Now when you can bring this down in size, smaller you make it, the flatter the design is going to look. So if you're looking to create buttons or, you know, bullets or something like that for maybe web design, all you have to do is scale this down. So I just wanted to show you this to give you an idea of what that texture is really going to look like. Because when you look at it, you know, like this, you're not really seeing all of the detail and the dimension because this area is so big. That's why I wanted to show it to you here. You can see the difference between the two. It's the exact same texture. The only difference is that this one, you're seeing it a lot closer. And then you can just come in and, you know, move it around to get the texture that you want. If you're interested in creating textures from scratch inside of Photoshop, I do have a full playlist that you can check out. I'm going to leave a link up here at the top so you can go through all of those. If you like this video, make sure to like, share, and subscribe to this channel, and visit prettywebz.com for more design resources and tutorials. Until next time, thanks for watching.